Welcome to the session. Today we will work with SQL loader or SQL star loader. It is an Oracle utility used to load data from the given data file into table or tables created in the database. The purpose of the SQL star loader is loading the data from external files. We are taking some files, either it may be text file or CSV file, flat file. We can name it as flat file. That text data we are moving into table. What tables it is? Database tables. Of an Oracle database tables we are moving. See how detailedly we can explain. See, you can observe how to move data to the database. Assume this is the notepad. Notepad contains various records. Assume I have taken 4 records. So this is what? Flat file. This is what? Flat file. So flat file is nothing but structured file which contains data. See, these are the data. These are structured file which contains data. This is a flat file. So we are loading this data into where? Into the database. Into the database. How we are moving this data into this database? With the help of the tool called SQL loader. So this SQL loader is a utility, Oracle utility, used to load data, this data from the given data file into where? We are moving, we are moving into the table. Whenever if you move into this table, the data will be moved into the database. This is how we are moving the data to the database. So let us understand in detail. So how the data will be moved into the database? How it will be moved? So we are writing one control file. With this control file, we are giving some instructions. We are writing some instructions. By understanding these instructions by the SQL loader, the corresponding data will be moved into the database. So you can observe the control file example. So in this, we have to issue one command, load data. That means we are loading the data. Where we are loading the data? We are loading to the table. This is what SARU is the table name. We are loading into this table. What data we are loading? At this path, having the file, this file contains the data. That data will be loading to this table. The meaning of it. So the infile is the class followed with the path of the file. What file it is? Flat file path. So here SCR is what? Table name. So we are loading the data to this table of this file specified in this path. And we are using some other options, fields terminated by. So you can have this file contains each and every column have some delimiters. So the delimiters having it is, it will be terminated by the comma. And also we are issuing the trailing null columns. So we have taken the three columns, assume one particular column have null records, that it also it will be handled with this option. So on top of the options keyword also there, it allows up to two errors. If you see zero, it allows only up to zero errors, it will stop the process. Otherwise, if we give two errors, it allows up to the two errors and it will process. That is the explanation about the control file. So what do you mean by control file? The SQL loader control file is a text file that contains data definition language instruction. What we explained earlier, that is what data definition language instructions. So what is the purpose of this control file? This SQL loader control file is used to load data from the CSV or flat file or data file to override. With the help of the control file only, we are loading the data to Oracle database table. So while loading from text file to database with the help of control file, the various files will be created. The most important file is log file. So what is the use of this log file? It contains a detailed summary of the load. What do you mean that? That means the what are the total records are successful, what are the total number of records are successful or unsuccessful records, error records, everything it will be captured in log file. What we can call as detailed summary of the load. Most of the log file entries are records of successful SQL loader execution. So during execution of this process, the various files will be created. One of the file is log file. Even some other files also created. So when this bad file will be created, so whenever rejected records, that means the bad file contains the rows that were rejected because of errors. Assume we have written one flat file, have some data in the flat file, have some, we are in the particular table having the data type varchar, but we are going to insert the data into the table as numeric characters. So that is what the bad file. So again, the discard file contains the rows that were discarded because they were filtered out because of a statement in the SQL loader control file. So let us illustrate with an example so that you can understand easily. Let us illustrate with example. So I am entering username and password. So this is what the text file I am taking. I can take this text file. So now I will use one control file. This control file I'm taking. Now I'm executing. So how can execute? That means how can load the data to the database table? To the command How the what is the command? SQL LDR username and password. We can take the password, press enter. It asks to place the control file path. So at which location the file is located? The file 1 is located under where? At this path. You can copy this path and paste it here. Again, so what file we are going to load? What file data we are going to load? File 1 data we are going to load. So copy it, paste it here. Dot txt. So now press enter. Oh, it gave some error. Let us concentrate on this error. So what type of error it is? Let us concentrate on it. So see, observe. We are moving into this table SARU. SARU. Okay, no? So just observe in this. Whether this table is created or not, check once. Select star from SARU. So data is available. So delete the data. Again, whether it is correct or not, once again check. SQL loader file 1.txt and get into table, table name, fields terminated by comma. These are the columns. Okay, no? So file 1. Okay. Execute once again. Will it execute or not? We'll check. So you can observe what is the error here. We have to write the control file name here, not the flat file name. So what is the control file name here? What is the control file name? SARU1.CTL. SARU1.CTL. Now you can observe. Yes. Check whether the data inserted or not into this file. Select star from SARU. Yes, data is inserted. Assume I am having this flat file. I am taking another column, another data, 04, Raghu. I did not mention any data of the third column. Let us illustrate with this. What happened? Let us check. Again, I am executing. Again, it is allowing us to load the data into this table. Let us check whether it will be inserted or not. Yes, it will be. So now what happens of this data? That means this file 1 what we have created, which is empty. This is the data which is empty. Where this row it will be moved? Where it will be moved? Can you please describe me? So it will be, that means one file will be created, the bad file. The bad file will be created. Let us look into this bad file. See. So whatever we mentioned, the lost line of the data which is empty, it will be moved into this bad file. So that was rejected because of the error. What error? We did not mention any data in the third column, so it is rejected. Again, these records also rejected. Why it is rejected? Because you can observe in file 1 having this data as well, but it did not insert. What happened? Because we have taken the data type for this column as number, but you are going to insert what type of data? Varchar to string data you are going to insert. So that's the reason it is not allowing to load into the table because of the data type mismatch, right? And also, why it is not inserting this column also not inserted, right? Because business rule validation, we have written the business rule validation as we have taken the first EMP number as a primary key. So we have taken constraint for that. The business rule validation is implemented. The data which is repeated, the data is not inserted. That's why it is rejected because of these errors: data type mismatch, business rule validation by applying the constraint, and as well as we are using null value of that row. That's why it is not allowing to load. So what the which data is loaded? You can observe which data is loaded. 1 Ramesh 2000. So this is perfect data. That means this data have no errors. That's why it is inserted. Okay, did you understand about the bad file? Bad file. See, the bad file contains the rows that were rejected because of errors. These errors might include bad data types or referential integrity constraints. So remaining the rest of the things we will discuss in next class. Thank you. Bye.